At first, drinking a beer feels almost innocent. One glass, one toast, one small celebration. After all, beer has been part of human culture for thousands of years, from the Egyptians to medieval Europe. But science reminds us, even the very first sip sets off a cascade of reactions in your body. Within minutes, alcohol enters your bloodstream and starts to alter brain chemistry. Dopamine rises, making you feel more relaxed, social, and even a bit euphoric. It's no wonder people describe it as a social lubricant. But this positive sensation is short-lived, a temporary mask that hides what's happening under the surface. The liver immediately kicks into high gear, working to break down ethanol, the active ingredient in alcohol. Your body treats it not as food, but as a toxin that needs urgent processing. For many, that reality is easy to ignore because the effects are subtle at first. This is where the illusion begins. One beer feels harmless, even beneficial to some. But science shows that the story changes rapidly when that one beer becomes a daily habit. Right after finishing a beer, your digestive system prioritizes alcohol metabolism. Unlike nutrients, alcohol doesn't need digestion. It gets absorbed almost instantly through the stomach lining and small intestine. This is why the buzz kicks in faster than food ever could. Blood alcohol levels rise, and your body begins to redistribute water to dilute it. That's why beer makes you urinate more. Alcohol suppresses vasopressin, the hormone that helps the kidneys retain water. You're literally draining hydration from your own cells. Meanwhile, your brain slows down communication between neurons. Reaction times drop, memory formation weakens, and your judgment becomes fuzzy. Even one beer can subtly affect coordination and concentration more than people realize. By the end of the first few hours, your body has worked overtime to process what seems like a small pleasure. For the casual drinker, this cycle ends here. But for someone repeating it every single day, the body never fully resets. A single beer may seem trivial, but science is clear. Repeated exposure rewires both the brain and the body. By the end of the first week, tolerance begins to build. The same amount of beer no longer delivers the same buzz, pushing many to crave more. This adaptation happens because your brain's receptors adjust. The dopamine reward becomes weaker over time, leaving behind more of the negative side effects without the same pleasure. It's a classic case of diminishing returns. Physically, your liver is forced to adapt as well. Enzymes that break down alcohol ramp up production, but this comes at a cost. Fat begins to accumulate in liver cells. The silent stage of fatty liver can start within weeks of daily drinking. So while many believe my liver is strong, it can handle it, the truth is that every daily beer is a silent strain. And after 30 days, the stress becomes measurable, even if you don't feel it. Quick thought for you. If you had to choose, what do you think takes the biggest hit after 30 days of daily beer? The liver, the brain, or your energy levels? Drop your guess in the comments. I'd love to see what you think before the big reveal. Most people think of beer's effect on the brain in terms of hangovers, headaches, dizziness, and brain fog the morning after. But daily drinking creates much deeper changes. Alcohol interferes with neurotransmitters like glutamate and GABA, altering how neurons communicate. This disruption impacts memory formation and learning capacity. Studies show that even moderate daily drinking reduces the brain's ability to form new connections, a process called neuroplasticity. Over time, this dulls cognitive sharpness. Another hidden effect is on mood regulation. Alcohol may give an initial dopamine boost, but it also increases cortisol, the stress hormone. This roller coaster leaves you more anxious or irritable the next day, often without realizing why. After 30 days, these small but constant disruptions add up. Your brain adapts to alcohol's presence, meaning your natural mood balance and focus are compromised, even when you're not drinking. One surprising consequence of daily beer consumption is its impact on immunity. At first, alcohol seems harmless, but it actually disrupts the production and activity of white blood cells, your body's defense soldiers. Science reveals that regular alcohol intake makes the immune system less efficient at fighting infections. This means you may catch colds more easily, heal slower, and feel fatigued without knowing the root cause. Alcohol also increases gut permeability, sometimes called leaky gut. Harmful bacteria and toxins can enter the bloodstream more easily, triggering chronic inflammation throughout the body.
So instead of strengthening you, a daily beer quietly weakens your resilience. By day 30, your body may look the same on the outside, but inside, your defenses are compromised. Many people claim a beer helps them relax and fall asleep. But what they don't realize is that alcohol sabotages sleep quality. While it may make you drowsy at first, it reduces REM sleep, the deep, restorative stage your brain and body crave. As a result, you wake up less refreshed, even after a full night's sleep. Over weeks, this deficit builds up, leading to fatigue, irritability, and reduced mental sharpness. It's like your internal battery never fully charges. Mood also takes a hit. Daily alcohol use interferes with serotonin balance, the happiness chemical. This contributes to mood swings and, in some cases, mild depression. People often drink to feel better, but the habit quietly fuels the very stress and sadness they hope to escape. Energy levels plummet as well. With disrupted sleep, poor nutrient absorption, and hormonal imbalances, you start to feel drained more often. That afternoon slump becomes your new normal. So what does the research say after 30 straight days of beer? Clinical studies have documented measurable changes in weight, liver function, blood pressure, and mood. Even moderate amounts show negative impacts. Liver enzyme tests often reveal early signs of stress, your body's red flag that damage is beginning. Blood sugar levels may also rise, increasing the risk of insulin resistance. Psychological studies confirm that cognitive performance declines with daily drinking. Reaction times slow, memory worsens, and problem-solving ability drops compared to non-drinkers. In short, 30 days of just one beer a day is not as harmless as it sounds. The science is clear. Your body keeps score, and the results are measurable. By the way, if you're curious about another 30-day challenge, don't miss our video, What Happens If You Cut Out Sugar Completely for 30 Days? The science behind that experiment might surprise you even more. After a month of daily drinking, the question remains, is it really worth it? The short-term pleasure is undeniable, moments of relaxation, laughter, and tradition. But the science paints a different picture, subtle but steady harm building beneath the surface. The truth is, beer isn't evil. It's the repetition that transforms a cultural habit into a health risk. Occasional toasts are unlikely to cause major damage, but daily drinking shifts the balance from enjoyment to burden. The body is resilient, but not invincible. The liver, brain, and immune system all whisper the same warning: give us a break. Recovery is possible, but only if you let your body breathe. So next time you raise a glass, ask yourself, is today's toast a celebration, or is it becoming a silent chain? Science suggests the answer lies not in the beer itself, but in the choices you make every day. And if you enjoyed this journey into the science of daily drinking, don't forget to like this video, subscribe to the channel, and share it with someone who might be curious, or maybe even a friend who never says no to a beer.